They showed off Battlefield 2042 gameplay. A lot of people were very excited about that. They thought it looked great. Personally, I mean, it just looked like more Battlefield to me. Like, it looked good, but I wasn't like, you know, going over the top about it. And I mean, like, personally, as someone who doesn't really play a lot of multiplayer only games, I can't feel like this footage didn't make me want to go out and spend $70 on a multiplayer only Battlefield game. Like, I get why people, it's going to be 70. Like, that's also my problem with it. Like, a lot of people were saying, like, oh, it's, like, I had someone who compared Battlefield being 70 to Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart being 70, which...
Ratchet & Clank is, like...
Don't correlate whatsoever.
Yeah, it's too, like, they're two, like, totally different experiences. And they're also for, like, two, I would say, distinctly different types of people, even.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
but the thing that I mostly... have a problem with Battlefield being 70 is when you say it's multiplayer only, even if people say that the Battlefield campaigns are never good, and you know, that's fine, I get why they would cut it out. That being multiplayer only with no campaign and at the moment not even like a battle royale thing seems like such a bare bones kind of thing.
Yeah.
And when you say multiplayer only to me, I imagine either free-to-play game with microtransactions or a $20 game. I don't imagine a game that is going to be $70 on next-gen consoles that has the most bare-bones of features. Like, that sounds bare-bones to me. And I know, like, the person who tried to compare it to Ratchet & Clank to me was like, oh, Ratchet & Clank is a 15 to 20-hour game, but Battlefield, you get 200 hours in, and... Personally, hot take, I think that gameplay hours are the most overvalued metric of a game's quality,
yeah,
but
yeah.
That's neither here nor there.
Right. It depends on the game itself.
But like, that's...
So.
Yeah.
I mean,
like, that's neither here nor there.
200 hours, but 190 of those hours are just garbage. Like,
yeah.
What's... There's nothing
exactly.
There.
Like,
I'd rather the excellent 15 to 20 hours that is Rift Apart than 200 repetitive hours of, you know, something that I'm not enjoying. So, but the point is, it's not even about the gameplay hours to me. It's, like I said, when you say multiplayer only with no campaign, no battle royale, it's the most bare-bones thing ever. I don't imagine a $70 game on next-gen consoles. I imagine a free-to-play or, like, at most, a budget-priced game at, like, 20. But instead, they're treating this like it's going to be a AAA $70 game. And that, to me, is where I'm just like, uh-uh.
No, that is kind
but,
of...
But, I mean, I guess, you know, people are happy the game looks good, so good for that. I'm glad people are excited for it. It's just, on a personal level, I have no interest in paying 70 for a game like that. But, moving away from my rantings and ravings about Battlefield...